New Ventures Company has been around here in the chamber. The company is 12 years old, and I've been doing this for a little bit longer than 12 years. Started it off as a sort of a freelance kind of thing off on the side, and then jumped into it as a full corporation, and then immediately joined the chamber. So I've been with the chamber all that time as well, and so I know many of you for, well, longer than some of you might admit that you're that old. So, but we've been doing these kinds of things for a long time, and I have been building websites for people for a long time, and I have been going to people's places and consulting with them on their websites. And what I've realized is the thing that I enjoy really the most of it all, and the thing that I feel that I'm best at, is brainstorming with them as to how their particular business can benefit by them using the internet. And it may not just be the website, it may be the website and a whole bunch of other things. And then what happens is, after all of that's done, then they'd like me to build a website, and now I have to go back and do work. So I'd much rather figure out a way that I can be consulting with people, helping them with that brainstorming stuff, and let people's nephews and other folks, some people that are in the business, Tony, other people like that, build the website for them, because that's what they do best. And so that's what I have been doing of late, is speaking and consulting. Not exclusively, there are some people that I still do websites for, that I still build their website and still maintain their websites. And I'll continue to do that for those folks. But for the majority of people, I will consult with them and pretty much like give them a prescription. These are the things that are important for your website. You should have, for instance, just the other day, Jim Guter, some of you know Jim Guter, he is a broker of big band music. He has a 18-piece orchestra, and he has, from that size down to a three-piece orchestra, or three-piece trio, and he took his trio, he's been playing at Timpano's almost every night, I think like Wednesday through Saturday or something is his schedule over there, and somebody filmed him. Well, they gave me those videotapes, and I put those little music clips as little music videos on YouTube. And he's been getting tremendous numbers of hits on YouTube for his little songs, because people enjoy hearing the songs, and then they realize, oh, Jim Guter does some nice music. Let me have them come to our party and do music for him. Now, that's not something that most people think is a thing to put on their website. In fact, Jim has had a website for a long time and has never had that on his website. So now he not only has the YouTube stuff out there where people stumble upon that when they look up Paper Moon or Route 66 or some of those classic jazz tunes or classic big band tunes. But they'll also see it on his website, because once you put it on YouTube, YouTube gives you the little codes that it takes to embed it onto your own website. So you go to Jim Guter's website and you see it play right there. So you get more bang for your buck. And you don't have to hire somebody that exclusively does video stuff for your website, because it may be a needle in a haystack. Nobody will see it if it's sitting only on your website on page 5 of your website. Whereas if it's out on YouTube, people will stumble upon it. And who knows, that person that stumbled upon it might be somebody big for you. So I am now doing more speaking engagements. I'm now doing more individual consulting, and enjoying it very much.